Welcome to a lesson on graphing the sine, cosine, and tangent functions on the TI84 graphing calculator. So the goal of this video is to be able to graph y equals cosine x on the graphing calculators we see here below, as well as generate the table as we see here in degree and radian mode. And we want to be able to do the same for y equals sine x and y equals tangent x. So let's go ahead and get our graphing calculator out. Let's first graph these in degree mode. So let's press the mode key. We're going to go down to row 3 and highlight degree. And then press enter. So if we're going to graph them in degree mode, we first have to set up the window as well as the table set. Let's press the window key. Because the period of cosine and sine is 360 degrees, let's set our x min and x max to negative 360. To positive 360. And we're going to scale it by increments of 15 degrees. And then the minimum and maximum values for cosine and sine are negative 1 and positive 1. So I'll go ahead and leave the y min at negative 2 and the y max at positive 2. Next, let's go ahead and set up our table of values. So I'm going to press second window. We'll have the table start at 0 degrees. And again, let's have it change by increments of 15 degrees. And now we're pretty much set to go. Let's go ahead and press y equals and enter in our functions. So y1 is going to be cosine x. And let's go ahead and press graph. And here's a nice graph of y equals cosine x showing two periods of the function. And if we press second graph, the x column represents the angle in degrees, and y1 would be the cosine function value. Now notice the calculator only gives us the decimal approximations for the irrational values of any of the trig functions. Let's go ahead and graph y equals sine x. What we're going to do is actually just turn this off by going over to the equal sign and then press enter, and now it's no longer highlighted. Let's press the down arrow and then y equals sine x in y2. And now if we press graph, because only sine x is highlighted, it's only going to graph the sine function. And again, it's graphing the function and showing two periods. Now if we press second graph, again, x represents the angle in degrees, and now y2 would be the sine function value. Let's go back to y equals just for a moment. If we turn them both on, the same time by pressing enter here. Again, notice both equal signs are darkened. If we go back to the table now by pressing second graph, y1 is the cosine function values, y2 are the sine function values. So these actually represent the coordinates of points on the unit circle. This column would be the x coordinates, and this column would be the y coordinates, because these are the cosine function values, which are equal to x on the unit circle, and these are the sine function values, which are equal to y on the unit circle. Okay, let's go ahead and finish by taking a look at the graph of y equals tangent x. Let's go ahead and turn these two off. And enter tangent x in y3. Remember, the range for tangent x is from negative infinity to positive infinity. So when we press graph, this gives us a decent graph of y equals tangent x. What we may want to do is press the window key and change the y min and y max. Let's go ahead and do that. Let's change the y min to negative 5 and the y max to positive 5. Press graph. It gives us a better perspective using this window. And again, if we press second graph, we see the tangent function values in y3. Remember, tangent x is equal to sine x divided by cosine x. And wherever we see an error, this represents where the tangent function would have a vertical asymptote. And because the period of tangent x is 180 degrees, the next error will show at 270 degrees. As we see here. Let's go ahead and turn the tangent function off. Go over the equal sign, press enter, and now they're all off. Let's go ahead and graph these in radian mode. So first press the mode key, change it to radians, press enter, and now we have to adjust the window and the table set for radian mode. So we press the window. The period for cosine theta and sine theta is 2 pi radians. So let's change this to negative 2 seconds. And then this caret here brings up the pi. When we press enter, it's going to convert this to a decimal. And then we'll type in positive 2 pi for the x max. And then our x scale, let's scale this by pi over 6 radians. So let's go ahead and press second caret divided by 6. Let's go ahead and change the y min and y max back to negative 2 through positive 2. And then we also have to change our table set. We're going to press second window, start at 0 radians, and then we'll have the change in the table, pi over 6 radians. Now once we've done this, it's going to be pretty much the same process as we showed before. Let's press y equals, let's go ahead and turn on the cosine function, press enter, and graph. And it looks like just what we had before, but now it's graphed in radian mode. If we were to press the trace key, now x will be in radians, and y will be the cosine function value. So one disadvantage of radians is that it's sometimes hard to interpret the actual angle measure when it's in decimal form and in radians. If we press second graph, x is the radian measure of the angle, and y1 would be the cosine function value. And we could do the same for y equals sine x and y equals tangent x, but we're going to go ahead and stop here for this video. I hope you found this helpful.